Hello dear students, I hope you all are taking care of yourself. Because of this COVID-19, we are going to teach all these things and hopes. So without wasting the time, today we will start the first lesson of the science, that is sources of food. Okay, so the sources of food means what? The first thing is that food, the very important thing in our daily life, or the whatever the work we are doing, it is only for to get the enough amount of the food. But the thing is that why it is necessary to eat the food? What is the reasons behind that? Why we are eating the food every day? So the food is very important for our body, because the food gives us different types of nutrients and the energy to our body to perform the different work. So let's see why we have to take the food of different types. So we need food too, or why we are taking the food? Why it is necessary to take the food every day? What are the needs to take the enough or the proper quantity of the food? So food is necessary for to get the energy to work and play. So to do the work, or to perform the different types of the work and to play, we requires the enough energy, and that energy we are getting to eat the different types of the food. So as you know, in the school you are making different type of the work, you are playing also. So to do that different type of the works and to play, we requires the food. Next is that we need the food to get nutrients for the growth and maintenance and repair of the body cells. Also we need the food to get the proper amounts of the nutrients. As we know, in your previous classes you have already seen that there are the different nutrients, for example carbohydrate, fats, protein, vitamins and minerals. So all these nutrients are necessary to our body for the proper growth of our body, and all these nutrients we are getting from the different types of the food and nuts. So we need the food to eat the food. We need food to get nutrients from. Why the nutrients are necessary for our body? For the proper growth of our body, and also it is necessary for the maintenance and repair of the body cell. So as we know, the human body is made up of the cell. Each and every part of the body, each and every organ of the body is made up of the cell. So to maintain that cells and to repair the body cells, sometimes some cuts happens on our body, some wounds are appears on our body, and without our knowing, all these things, this cut get, these other slowly slowly get healed from our body. So how this happens? Because of these different nutrients. So these nutrients are helpful for the proper growth, and also it keeps our body, it maintains our body, and also repairs our body, damaged body parts. Next one, we need the food to protect us from the diseases and be fit and healthy. So as you know, vitamins and minerals are called as protective food. Why they are called as protective food? Because they help our body to fight against the different diseases. This is what they protect us from the different diseases, and also they keep our body fit and healthy. So these are the things why we are eating the food. Because to get energy, to get the nutrients for the growth, to maintain and to keep care of the body cells, and also to protect us from the different diseases and to keep us fit and healthy. So these are the things, or these are the need for that means we are eating the food every day. Now for our next point is that, so these food items we are getting from the different food varieties, or in our daily diet we are eating the different food varieties. Sometimes we are eating the dal, we are eating rice, chapati, roti, different types of the vegetables. Okay, so all these are called food variety. So to make the different types of the food, to make the food we require the certain substances. Okay, and the certain substances are called as ingredients. So what is meant by ingredients? What is the specific definition of ingredients? The materials needed to prepare the food items are called ingredients. Okay, again I will repeat, the materials needed to prepare the food items are called ingredients. Okay, means suppose if you want to make a rice, plain rice, so which types of the ingredients you will require? For example, we are talking about the boiled rice or the steamed rice, we require the rice, we require requires the water. So with the help of these two ingredients we can make the rice. So rice and water, these are the ingredients that we require to make a plain rice. But if you want to make a dal, to make the dal we require the so many different types of the ingredients. We require oil, we require dal, we require mustard, cumin seed, curry leaves, turmeric powder, cumin powder, and there are so many ingredients we are adding into the dal as per our convenience or as per our taste, and we are making the dal. If you want to make the potato sabzi or if you want to make the potato vegetable, then we require the potato, cumin seed, mustard, oil, turmeric, curry leaves, okay, chili. So all these are the different ingredients we are using to make the potato vegetables. So some food items require to be more ingredients to make a food stuff, or some food substances we can make by using 1 to 2 to 3 ingredients. Okay, so these are the ingredients, the material needed to make a prepare food items are called ingredients. Now the next point we will discuss, that is sources of food. So here we have discussed about the ingredients, but from where all these ingredients come, from where all these food substances come? So sources of the food means what? From where we are getting the food. So the basically we are getting the food from the plants and animals. So the plants and animals are the sources of the food. For example, if we talk about the plants, then all the fruits, all the vegetables, all these things we are getting from the plants. And if we talk about the animals, from the animals we are getting the meat, we are getting the eggs, we are getting the milk, all the meat products. So whatever the meat products we are getting, that all we are prepared from the meat, and that we are getting from the animals. Also we are getting the honey, wax, all these things we are getting from the animals. Okay, so the plants and animals are the sources of the food. We are getting all the food material. We whatever the food material we are getting, that either come from the plants or it may be get from the animals. Okay. Now the next one, the part of the plant that can be eaten are called edible parts. Suppose we are taking the vegetables, so all the parts of the vegetables we are not eating. If we are taking the spinach vegetable, then only leaves we are taking and remaining the part of that spinach we are throwing. So the leaf of that spinach is the edible parts. Okay, so the parts of the plants that can be eaten, the part of the plant that we are eating, that parts are called as edible parts. If we will talk about the banana, then we have peel of the banana and then we are eating. Means the inner part, one portion we are eating, pulp portion we are eating, and the peel we are throwing. That pulp portion is the edible part of the banana. So these are about the edible parts of a plant. Okay, different foodstuffs are having different types of the edible parts. So today we have discussed about we need food too, why we need food. Also we have discussed about the food variety. So food variety means what? There are the sources of the foods also. Plants and animals are the sources of the food. So the next points we will discuss in the next point for today. Thank you.